It's time for Big Tigger's Trending Topics. Yeah, that's trending topic. On V103.
Alrighty, people. Time for the Trending Topics. 411 and all your favorite folks. Lots of stuff going on. Where do I want to start? Let's start with Blackish creator Kenya Barris. Another creator. Been married for 20 years to his wife, Dr. Is it Rania? Rania. Rainbow. Y'all know who it is. Anyway, married 20 years. Filed for divorce. Filed documents in L.A. Superior Court Friday, which also marked his 45th birthday. Wow. According to reports, he also filed in 2014, same year Blackish premiered, but later withdrew. So maybe they tried to work it out, and now they can't. Lots of conversation about who's going to be do what, because the main character in Blackish is lightly based on his wife. He's got another spinoff, which is kind of about how the wife grew up. So could get messy. Stick around for that. Speaking of marriage, lots of rumors going around that Nicki Minaj had eloped. She got to clear it up on Queen Radio. Denied that she had, in fact, eloped. There were reports that her and Kenneth Perry took out a marriage license in the City of Angels. People in the Beverly Hills courthouse spotted them at the marriage license bureau window. Nicki was reportedly trying to keep it low in a hat. Perry paid for the license. She addressed the speculation, saying, we filed for the marriage license. Yeah, we did that. Now we have the marriage license, and from that time, we have 90 days to get married. She said, I don't want to do the big wedding now. I want to get married now, and then we'll do the big wedding later. I'll be married before my album comes out. I'll probably have my wedding after the album. I mean, that's what's up. Congratulations. Not so happy a union happened on her show when Joe Budden was a guest. He appeared on her show. Initially appeared, the pair would attempt to iron out their differences. Joe had previously stated he believed on IG Live, you know, the Meg and Nicki thing, which was awesome, if you ask me. It was all staged and it was all part of the single rollout. The conversation started to take a turn when this happened.
You said many times that I lied, that I didn't know another was on a song I was on.
Here's my question.
And now you want
to
address it.
Can I ask a question now? Was Nicki Minaj and Cardi B on the Motorsport record directing bars at each other?
So what the f***? I'm not going to change the subject. I'm asking you a question.
That's the same subject.
No, the f*** it's not. I said I knew the bitch was on a song. You said she didn't know she was on a song.
I don't believe that I said that, if you want to get
oh
this.
My God.
You believe that Nicki Minaj was aware that Cardi B was the girlfriend?
Do you have a twin? It's okay for you to get up there and make me sound crazy and say I'm on drugs, right? Nah, well, you true. Like tearing down women when they can't defend themselves.
Man, who gives a f*** what she popped? But don't sit here and say you ain't popped a f*** pill.
I never said that.
An apple.
I never you said that, you dumb f***.
Don't do that.
Are you that dumb?
You asked.
Cut his mic.
Wow. Apparently Joe left. His other castmates, Mal and Rory, stayed. Buttons filled it up with some tweets and was like, I live for this. Spicy. I'm sure there'll be more. Will Nicki make a diss record, a Joe record? A Nicki dissing Joe Buttons record. Think so? Does she want that? What, you don't think Joe Biden is gonna respond to this record? He just gotta keep it real careful with the response. That's gonna be crazy. We'll keep you posted whatever happens. That's it for the trending topics. Miss any part? VDAS103.com. More Big Tigger Show now.